André Rieu is one of the most loved and successful artists on the planet, and his extravagant concerts often outsell gigs by Coldplay, Elton John, and even Madonna. André is about to head our way again on his Christmas with André tour, but first he's going to speak with us. And it is a very good morning, André from Australia. Hello.
Hello, hello.
Now, your latest album is called Amore, which is Italian for love, and you've been married to the gorgeous Marjorie for over 40 years. Now, tell us, what's the most romantic thing you've ever done for your gorgeous wife?
First, I'm married now, this year, 42 years, almost 33 years. The most romantic thing I ever did for Marjorie, I remember, she wrote my biography. And I was so touched by it that she did that, that I went to a juwelier, how do you say that? And he made a golden book and with our both our names on it, and she always wears it. That was what I did for her.
Oh, that is so romantic, André. Okay, 42 years, secret to a happy marriage?
To a happy marriage, in my case, I cannot tell for every for other people, but in my case, go very often on tour. No, I'm serious. I think, you know, it's fantastic to love each other, but 43 years sitting on the couch together holding hands, that's not a recipe to be happy. So I think respect for each other and let the other live his life or her life. And that's, I think, the recipe for a happy marriage.
Now, André, your fans are always giving you gifts. Do you like receiving or giving the gifts?
I am a giving one. I love to give. Marjorie always says, you give so much. When you are on stage, the people ask more and more, and you give them, and you give them. And I think, you know, it's a pleasure to give.
I got to tell you, André, 2018, what a busy year. You've performed Mexico, Israel, Germany, Austria, Poland, Croatia, Denmark, Argentina, US, and of course Australia. Come on, which is your fave?
What's my favourite? What do you think? My second homeland, Australia.
Yay!
I'm looking forward to come in November. For the first time, we are going to give Christmas concert. And in the town hall in Sydney, we are going to make a very special thing.
Oh, you're such a charm. You know exactly what to say. You are celebrating your 30th year on the road now. Your first big tour was in Chicago in the United States. What do you remember from those early days? Any memories stand out for you?
In fact, I can tell you first, it's 31 years, the 31st. So 30 was last year. My answer can be that from the first tour we did, it's exactly the same as we are now. Of course, we were less on stage. I think the first tour we were 25 or even 20. Now we are 60, sometimes 70 on stage. It's a whole family traveling around the world, but the spirit is the same. We play with our hearts. The whole orchestra, all my members, they sit there and play with their hearts. And that's the spirit, and that spirit was already there the very first concert.
Wow. You are so busy, and thank you very much. I did have an opportunity to visit with you at your beautiful castle in Maastricht. But how do you unwind?
That's a very simple answer. I sleep. I sleep very, very much and very often. Marjorie always says, you are four horses who run or you sleep. And that's true. I'm running or I sleep. So unwinding for me, I do that every day, several times. I sleep always in the bus, in the plane, before I go on stage, after I go on stage. In fact, I'm a very dull sleeping person.
I don't believe that. Now, you have sold over 40 million albums, but what sort of music do you listen to?
I never listen to music, never. The whole bus around me, in the plane, everybody, always with these ears, I never, you know? And that's so I can be fresh again, because music is my life. I'm always making music, so when I don't be on stage, I don't listen to music.
So do you have a favourite style of music then?
My father was a conductor of classical music, and in my home was only classical music, and we were, as kids, not allowed to listen to other music. But now, for me, with my kids and my grandkids, we listen to everything. You know, for me, there's only good or bad music. And what is good music? Good music is music that you play with your heart, because then it will touch you and it will touch the audience.
And little birdie told me you perhaps like some of the boss's music.
Yes, yes. How do you know that? Bruce Springsteen. It's true. I admire him, and that's one of my dreams, that we could be together on stage once. Who knows?
Now, if you weren't a musician, what do you think you would have been, André?
If I would not be a musician, I would be an architect. I love building. I think as long as you build, you live. And so I am always building and renovating. This garden you see here, I built it myself. It just finished, and you know, that's what I like. That's what I like, building and renovating.
Oh, André, it is always great catching up with you, and we can't wait to see you back in Australia. Travel safe, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you very much. It was nice to talk to you, and I love it to come to Australia. Give my kiss to everybody.
We all giggle nervously,
yes,
don't we?
Now, before we go anywhere, can you take us back? You spend some time?
I did.
With André?
I got to go to Maastricht, which is where he's home. And, in fact, where he was standing, that's an outdoor area with the most beautiful garden. And then we caught, wait for it, sorry, girls, the private plane to Dresden, where he was doing a press conference. And that's the said private plane. You know, I could quite get used to that.
Oh, my
You just
gosh.
Jump out of the plane, you sort of don't even need a passport, you pass through, and that's one of the rooms in his castle in Maastricht.
That he claims to be renovating himself. Surely
yes.
This can't be true.
He points a lot.
Conducts.
Yes, but the design, as an architect, they've got these beautiful architraves in what he's done, and he does love that sort of artwork. But he is a really interesting guy. His father was a conductor, as he said, but a very, very strict and stern man. There was nothing but music in that household. And I got to waltz with him in the square where he does a huge concert, live concert around Europe every year. It is, you know, he's an extraordinary person.
Hang on. You got to waltz with him. Like, but wouldn't he have been playing?
No, well, yes, but he gave me a bit of waltz.
It was a good dancer.
I was shocking. He was great.
You were dancing with the stars.
No.
Did you do a waltz?
Yeah, did a bit of a waltz, yes. Yeah, I'm not sure it was that great. But his staff have been with him like 25, 30 years.
Wow.
Yeah, and it's a really tightly well-produced show. So a very interesting human being. He was very poor when he and Marjorie were first together. He literally was doing the equivalent of, you know, little tiny clubs with 10 people about. And they took about 10, 15 years to start to build to the magnificent shows that he does now. It's been a long time.
Wow. And I loved what he said about he and Marjorie's relationship and how it
worked. Stay apart.
Yeah. Stay apart. And I thought, I must tell John, because I'm coming to Sydney every second week.
Is it working
Brilliant,
for you?
Marvellous.
We're saving your relationship.
That's right.
One Nutribullet at a time. Now, André's current album, Amore, is in stores now. But wait, there's more. Next month, he'll release Romantic Moments 2. The Christmas tour with André will kick off in Melbourne on the 17th of November before heading to Sydney on the 21st and 22nd, and then he goes to Perth on the 24th of November. And André has just added one more Sydney date. You can catch the Dutch King of the Waltz on Thursday, the 22nd of November at the ICC Theatre in Sydney. You can head to andrerieu.com for more details.